Thirsty, trying to choose. I mean, I know I'm pretty cool. My nitty bag, my kitty boots. I got the juice, I got the juice.
10-0, Chatham's on. Foolie's glad I'm home. Even my haters kinda glad I'm on. Rest in peace to my vagabond. Rapper, song, singer, suspended, subpoena. For misdemeanors, dreamer, held back asses. Loki still a dinner. And I still shake a bull squat. Ram for my broke. Got city on the come up. Shot that nigga Sosa. Shot my nigga Fat Trail. Shot my nigga Joseph. Playing Buenos Aires while they sleeping Buenos Noches. Wonder if I wrote this. Cause it's so crisp. The most brokest gold stock broker when a solstice. I could win an Oscar. Russian accent Husky.
Where's the boost? He's dead. Oh, Jesus, I'm bad. Watch the handoff.
They forced me into the ground with the bomb.
Don't worry, I'm there.
Yeah. I'm leaving.
Oh my god, I'm awful right now. Holy shit.
Alright.
Can't close it though. Amy going for that rub. Selfie dangerous with this juke juice. Outpass 3. Anti.
Oh! One steals it. That was a great move.
Get fucked.
What is Arby doing?
It's come one from bottom boost.
He was getting to anti. Oh!
Oh my god, he's so clean.
Skinny Tommy that. Nice, Ned. Can you rush back to base?
Bottom. Yeah.
Where's the boost? I'm past the couple.
I have tag, just wait.
Yeah, I feel.
I'm waiting. Don't worry.
What?
I told you to.
Really pushed on four tiles. Loki's LeBond it.
Berk was like,
good save by Frozen after all LeBond it.
The best part is we'd always say he LeBond it, and then one time LeBron fucked it up.
He's gonna use Ball and Wise own play against him. It doesn't work. Ball and Wise sees it coming.
It's because you need two tag pros for that.
Yeah, you need a tag pro on play.
FC's gotta have one.
Oh, under, through.
Oh.
See, when are you gonna say it? It's always the last thing he said.
You know, your intuition should be good enough. Because... that never works, Bono.
He's heard you, dude.
Get
out of the house.
Whoa! What?
It's too OP.
Frozen.
Snipe. Water wheel.
Frozen with the juice.
Need a block.
Frozen's gonna.
Back up.
Don't die.
Oh! Nice. Oh! Clean! Three. Is new guy gonna kiss? Yes, he is. Uh oh. This isn't looking good. Bottom line's gotta go huge.
Uh oh.
Water wheel! Water wheel! It's a god! Kiss him!
Bomb spawn.
Returns a cat for half a second, not anymore. Returns a cat for Toasty, he nubs them here. Watch this. Boom, 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 nub.
Look at the combo boost.
That's the Toasty. Oh!
Another pass through. That's the tilter. That's game.
Oh, no.
It's game. Oh my god. My bad, he's right.
Go left. You had the cap.
I'm better than CJ, please.
Wrong.
Arby's been here.
Oh no, Sophie's done bottom line. Clip it, that's an upstep.
Ah!
Throwing?
Thank you. Ungodly
chemistry. Oh, bottle light! No!
Oh my god.
Another pixel perfect cap. Ooh, Bright spikes one and is out past two, and he gets an RB with the flag. Dope tries to defuse him, misses the snipe. Bright might be able to get his own return here. Oh my god, that was clean.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Your grace. Is that my flamethrower beside you?
Why, it is.
Please, sir, pass it this way.
Can you hand me that pistol?
Please don't get
my lord. My lord, please hand me the bazooka.
Thank you. No blood on the couch, please. Please, no blood on the couch.
Yes.
So
sure you got blood on the couch.
Can you hear me that machine?
Damn you.
Yeah. Get my gun, we about to rob a Wells Fargo. Cause I'm robbing you to get a whole car low. When my dogs, we pull up looking like a car show. Pull the blood and then they get up on my narco.
Father God in heaven above, I come to you as humbly as I know how. I'm hella the drugs and I'm out of my mind. In the meantime, I'ma just smoke this loud. Put the shit on my tongue and the shit is up. Hit a shot of Hennessy just to wash it down. I'm a white man, tell me talking proper now. I got the BET still, so I'm hopping now.
Yeah, he without sin cast the first stone. So a nigga with a gun, nigga running your home. One dome shot, niggas are never looking them wrong again. Oh my God, on this licking. They call twisted, coming to bitch. Suck on my dick, some of the fun, none of your sister. Come, come, give me some tongue, tongue, get it done. Yum, fun, yum, 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 I'm twisted. Whatever I said, I don't know what I said, I don't give a fuck.
You getting this? You recording this? How you getting this?
Yo, roses is falling, the money is calling. I'm better forever and ever to you. Taking the boxes, the chocolate, I'll send them, I'll ship them, I'll get them delivered to you. Baby, whatever, just come on, just hop in the kid in the car and we're going to get booed. Dragons is off in the fall or whatever, just tell them to tell them and I need a move.
Skirt, skirt in the new thing. Throw the cash and you get a Raekwon like the Wu-Tang. I think I deserve me and Moosane. Me, you and two or three hoes should do the group thing. Just don't fuck up the shit, the Airbnb and fuck off the leaves. Mind your peace, I need peace of mind. I beat me to leave.
Yeah, yeah. Cause I'm robbing you to get a whole car low. When my dogs, we pull up looking like a car show. Pull the blood and then they get up on my narcos.
Hello?
Hello?
Is this thing on?
Oh, it's on.
Nice. I gotta get my music quieted down. Hold on. I'm pretty sure it's down. Okay, nice. So, this masterpiece of a slideshow. Okay. See if I can get this to work. Oh, nice. I got it. I got the technology.
We've got it down.
Alright, what do you got here? Map schedule. Very nice, very nice. Anything noteworthy you thought while you're making that?
I just looked at the maps that they had throughout the season, where they did well, where they lost, to try and anticipate what the map selection. And I think, based off what I saw, like Blue Hot Chili Peppers might try to ban Rush. They're 1-2 on Rush, including playoffs. And then I thought on the other end that Cap Hazard might try to ban either Jardim or Pilot 2, where they've struggled this season both times.
So I actually played Cap Hazard on Jardim in game one of the Equidistant 8, and I was really impressed by them. They ended up beating us by one, but I thought they played really well, and I wouldn't be surprised to see them choose it. That was their choice in the Equidistant 8 as well.
Really? That's surprising to me. They were 0-2, and then they did against you guys. Like you said, it went to overtime. I feel like they'd want to play a safer map, but maybe they're very confident on the map, so...
Yeah, I mean, it'll be really interesting to see. I mean, the pick ban is obviously, it's so hard to read into what teams are thinking.
Right.
But I mean, what you said definitely makes sense. It's just that, like, also, I know that they, even if their results don't look that good on Jardim, I think that it is one of their favorite.
Interesting, okay.
They also could have very well scrimmed on it after the season ended or near the end of the season, because that's a great way to prepare yourselves going into playoffs, kind of get better at your worst map or your worst couple maps.
Yeah, that's a good point. That's a great strategy if you come in over aggressive on a map that you expect to have selected instead of banning it, then you're going to come out ahead.
Yeah, take some teams by surprise. Statistics. Nice. All right, so we have the offense for Cap Hazard. So do we have it confirmed that Remo, Slice, and Juke of you are playing?
Well, I know that's how they played us.
Okay.
So, yeah, I think the Cap Hazard offense is Remo and Juke, and I know everybody's pretty high on Remo right now, so.
Yeah, I mean, his stats don't look that good, but his play is much better than the stats. I mean, 120 minutes. So
right, I think when
the counting stats.
Exactly, yeah. And I think, like, his niche is a little lower based off how he's played. From what I saw, I've only watched two games of Miners this season, but one of them was the Cap Hazard first-round game against you guys, and he played exceptionally well.
Yeah, he was a monster.
And then, so alongside him, there's Juke of Yore as well. So out of the two, how do these two work together, would you say? Who's
Juke
the carry?
I think they work really well together. I think Juke of Yore is the more aggressive. I mean, it's a little bit harder for me to say because, like, I was playing offense and they were playing offense. So, you know, ideally we were on the opposite sides of the map. But I felt like Juke of Yore was the more aggressive and Remo was playing a little bit more supporty, but... Honestly, either one of them can take either role up with ease. You know, I think of Juke of Yore more as a defender traditionally, but he's shown that he's absolutely a two-way ball this season. He's had an excellent season on offense. And I don't really... Remo is less of maybe a known quantity, but they've just meshed so well together.
Yeah, in this case, I feel like the numbers don't really lie. Juke of Yore is really, he in the game I watched, he was definitely the more aggressive of the two, with Remo taking more of a supporting role. But Remo was still excellent on his own. It's not like he was just sitting there waiting for Juke to do everything. He was extremely Juki when he did have the flag. But Juki Orr's numbers seem to be right on the money, like 8.75 in minors is a very impressive OGASP, so.
Yeah, for sure. And then their defense, Q42 and Sundown. Now, I feel like that's just as, if not more scary than their offense, but...
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, Q42 is the truth, and I mean, he showed it in majors as well. The niche is a little bit lower than I would have expected, considering the way that, the way that I've seen him play and the way that I've played against, that he's played against me. Sundown also not to be overlooked at all. And again, like, I feel like this whole team is a team where there's not that much flash, but there's a great deal of substance. And like, I mean, as Jam was saying, you know, the stats, all around they're pretty good, but I'm looking at the niches for all four players and they're lower than I would expect to see for a Mooper Ball team. But I think, I mean, all around offense and defense, the strength of this team is that they just work so well together. They communicate well, and they knocked out TC Jukes in really impressive fashion. And I think it was a factor of these are four balls who play together rather than playing next to each other.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I'd agree with that. And I think when you look at the numbers too, 311 returns and 305 returns, that's 12th and 13th. And you say, oh, that's not that high. But when you combine those two, and that it just shows they play really well together. Nobody's like becoming a top heavy in the stats. They're just working as a unit and doing everything right. So.
Okay, moving on to the Chili Poppers. So easy and dope on offense. I mean, it's two. Dope has some very nice stats. Second place in both caps and hold.
Yeah, I mean, Dope is just not a minors player. He put up really respectable stats in majors, and I remember at the beginning of the season, we did a private tryout that we invited Dope to, and we had a lot of really good players there, and he just absolutely took over every game that he was playing. He's got the ability to just make individual plays that are off the charts, absurdly good.
Yeah.
He can, from offense, he can carry a team, he can carry a defense from offense.
He almost reminds me of Toasty when he plays sometimes. It's like, absolutely. I'll see him with the flag, I'll look away, maybe at chat, and then I'll look back and he's out. And I thought he was dead, so I didn't even bother looking.
Yeah, Dope has the ability to carry the team all on his own as an offensive player, which is a difficult thing to do. I think Easy is an excellent support, or Ez, if you prefer. He's an excellent support offensive player, and he's also excellent at carrying the flag. So they're a really good tandem where Ez will do the little things, and Dope can do like the sparky plays without having to worry that one mistake will cost them.
Yeah, absolutely. I feel like Easy or Ez, whatever. I always said Easy.
It's Easy, yeah. It's like we jokingly call him Ez.
He's a perfect partner for Dope. He gives Dope an incredible amount of freedom. And I don't mean to like pour all of this onto Dope, because Easy has had an excellent season, like at 29 caps. That's really solid. But he just provides a great stable foundation for Dope to work off of.
Yeah.
And I think that's just as important as what he does with the flag.
Yeah. And I play sport offense too. And I think it's one of the underrated things is just not putting your team in a bad position when your more aggressive player is making plays. If you're not giving them an opportunity to like double flaccid or whatever so they can get out, that's big. And I think that's the pressure is going to be on Easy to make sure that he plays a heady game.
Yeah, particularly against such a well-coordinated defense.
Exactly, yeah.
They kind of have to outsmart the defense.
Yeah, let's move on to their defense then, actually.
Yeah, actually, I wanted to ask you what you guys about this. So Shrimpster played NLTPB. It looked like he was a rookie based off what I was seeing. There wasn't a lot of stats there. And now jumping two divisions, like jumping from B to A is kind of a step up, but jumping two full divisions is such a tall task. How do you guys feel that? Obviously, he's performed well. But how do you feel in the finals? Is the pressure going to be a bit higher than it's been before?
I don't think so, actually. I think one of the wonderful things about being a rookie is that the pressure doesn't exist in the same way. You know, you play pubs and every pubber, you know, and when you're playing pubs, you always think you're the best player because, I mean, chances are if you're playing competitive, you are the best player in any given pub.
Yeah.
And I feel like a lack of context, so for me, I played 5 seasons of B Team before making the same leap that Shrimpster has, skipping
oh, wow.
the team
yeah.
and going straight to minors. And for me, that was nerve-wracking. But I feel like if I had had no context, if I'd just been drafted, didn't really... I'm not saying he doesn't understand the way that LTP works, of course, but I feel like if I hadn't spent so much time at the lowest level before jumping up, I wouldn't have felt nearly as out of my depth. I think this is a good way to just dump somebody in the deep end and see if their talent works.
He very yeah. much, this very much reminds me of the jump ball situation.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's almost you could put them side by side and you're looking at almost the same kind of thing.
And one of the things to point out on the B stats, his D Nish is only 79, but the team Nish is a 97, which is very impressive. So
yeah, and he's been playing both ways on B team. He wasn't quite able to carry his team into the booper of one very, very close game 7, 6-minute overtime short.
Yeah, that was a heck of a game.
That was so much fun. But yeah, I mean, he can contribute to both sides of the field, absolutely.
And his partner in Horace is fantastic, too. Oh, we haven't yeah. really talked about him, but Horace is he's kind of had to adapt his role from being more of like a what I call a support defender into being the more aggressive, like kind of the backbone here. Like just because he has the experience and it's working out very well for Blue High.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, Horace he's been around forever. He's incredibly smart. He doesn't actually need those timers, even if they did. Sorry, we had to. I'm looking at this. It says 95 Nish O. Is that supposed to be D?
Oh, that's supposed to be D. Yeah, yeah. Okay, I figured. That's just a typo. Come on, Jam, get it together.
Jesus Christ, man. He's clearly. I mean, look, you look at the returns and the prevent 20th and 21st. That's not really, you know, what you would expect from a Mooper ball. From the guy who's carrying a Mooper ball defense, nothing against Shrimp, but Horace has been the lead guy here. But and you look at that Dinish, and I don't know what alternate stats are feeding into that. Clearly not the two main stats that you tend to look at
yeah.
when you look at
right,
defenders,
yeah.
but he's very clearly doing something right there, and I mean, he's a fantastic player.
And we can see, if we go to the next slide, his the partner he played off of, I just listed him as wild card all season, was Balmer. And Balmer, I feel like maybe they kind of swapped roles. Like Balmer was the more aggressive one. Horse was playing like contain, and then they switched it up in the playoffs, and Horse said, all right, like I got this. Don't worry. Let me throw you on my back, young Shrimpster, and show you how it's done. But yeah, Balmer had, it's a similar situation with the, my dog is biting my leg. Stop it, buddy. It's a similar situation with the other team. Like the numbers aren't great, but when you put them together, it tells more of a story of, oh, okay, they're just working together. They're not stealing stats and they're getting it done.
Absolutely.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, when I think of a team that put up like great, great, great numbers, I think this season of TC Jukes,
yeah.
who Cap Hazard were able to get past in order to make it here. So,
yeah, and neither of these teams are, these aren't like Cinderella stories, the number
oh,
two
absolutely
and number
not.
Three team. 7-3-0-4, and then Cap Hazard 7-2-0-5. Like, they've earned it. They've been there all seasons.
Yeah. But I think that's a testament to the way that team play will trump individual
yeah.
play every single time, or most times at least. But I mean, that's how both of these teams have gotten to the move, and they're going to continue to try to ride that. Which I think. For me, the most exciting kind of tag pro to watch is a team game. Like, it's always fun to see dank caps and great snipes and stuff. But when the teams are working together, that just, to me, creates so much excitement. It's just, I like seeing teams that are well coordinated, and I think we have two teams that are really well coordinated.
Yeah, I was going to say, you're going to love tonight, because it looks like both these teams, they work together very, very
well. Yeah. I'm very excited.
Oh, this is my write-up. How exciting.
Yeah, I mean, I think we've covered.
Yeah, we've gone over it.
We've covered most everything.
I'd just like to point out my terrible joke about horse. At the very bottom of the
animal all together. Oh, boo.
I'm not sure what the font is, fancy man. I can tell you later, though. I'll look into it for you, buddy.
It's a nice looking font.
This is the wrong slide, actually, and that's my mistake. I had put the previous week's.
All right, let's just get away from that.
I can go over what he wrote. I have it written down.
Yeah, is it mostly what we talked about, or did he have any other?
He kind of went into detail about the playoff run a little more.
Yeah, right.
This is Seven's words. BHCP did well to beat Run the Jukes and the Ballistics to get to the Mooper. Very little hiccups along the way. Dope and Easy have been having their way with defenses, and Bomber Shrimpster have been having their way with offenses. Against the Baltastics, BHCP had a 2-1 victory, winning Pilot 2, 6-3, losing Rush, 8-2, and then pulling it back to win 14-4 on Emerald. That's very impressive. This team has the tools to win, and will look to leverage their offensive prowess to disrupt the enemy team. The key to victory for BHCP is to step up and shut down the CPH offense so that their own offense can do the explosive wild things to beat out this robust CPH defense. And then for Cap Hazards, he says Cap Hazards have been cruising after a good start to the season and made it to the playoffs as the number 3 seed. They had 2 close games on their way to the Mooper against a solid Gateful Dead team. Oh, sorry, Amy. You hate to hear it. And then
I'll take the solid.
Yeah, it was a great, that was the game I watched, and it was great. Q42 and Sundown continue to be a lockdown defense, and Remo Slice continues to do things on offense with or without the help of Chukior. Chukior continues to not be a liability, and hopefully has gotten enough practice with his majors team to actually contribute something to the CPH cause.
Oh,
Cap Hazard lost 6-2 on Catch 22, 1-7-4 on Pilot 2, and pulling off the reverse sweep 1-11-5 on Rush. Key to victory here is the Cap Hazard offense to get out enough times, give the Cap Hazard defense enough time to get reset in the base, set up blocks, and work like a well-oiled machine.
I like the VLC traffic cones.
Yeah, Sevens.
Okay. What's gonna sound like popcorn? Nice.
Yeah, I made up some cheesy slogans.
Right. So, I don't know if they've done the picker ban yet, or what's going on?
Yeah, do we have a link so we can get in?
Yeah, we probably should get a link at some point.
Do you want to do a who you got type thing?
Yeah, sure.
All right, BC, who you got,
buddy? Hold on a sec. I gotta remember whose team. My fucking memory's not that.
We got the potato streamer here.
Dude, I got a million things going on in my mind right now. You don't even know. Just kidding. I don't know miners. Whatever.
Well,
team...
it's Easy and Dope on Blue
Hot.
And
so then... I think that. Ooh. I think Blue Hot Chili Poppers will win game one, and then Cap Hazards will win the other two games. I think Dope will come out crazy and just kind of pop off game one, but the thing with Dope is that he tilts super easy, and if he's not playing well, he's really not playing well. So I think the Cap Hazards will be able to come back game two, and it'll be enough to put Dope on the tilt, and they will take the series after that.
Do you think they'll employ any type of strategy as like a 3D to frustrate him early?
Absolutely. 100% they will. That is so important, I think, when you are against a player who, you know, if you've ever watched a game that Dope plays, he types in chat after every play. So he wears his heart on his sleeve when he plays, and that's something that you can very easily target.
Yeah, I mean, I've had success in my career against Duke by playing anti and kissing him every time he has.
Oh, do you think there's going to be a lot of kisses in this game? That's another good strategy against a heavy flag holder.
Well, I mean, I think there's going to be... Well, we saw last season in the Super Bowl, we saw like kind of an evolution in strats, particularly the 3D against a power-up advantage and stuff. And I, as kind of the logical continuation of that, I think you've got two teams that we keep saying they work well together, their tactics are good. And yeah, I would imagine you can see a lot of really intelligent anti and going for kisses at good times. These are two unselfish teams. And I think you'll see a lot of that, yeah.
What do you have, Amy?
I'm going to say Cap Hazards in two, but I'm also going to admit that that's mostly because they knocked us out, and I want to say that we lost the eventual championship.
Bias.
That's a good bias. I like that. As for me, I haven't really played with many of these players before, so I'm at a bit of a disadvantage. I've played with EZ. And I played against Shrimpster a bit. But the rest of the guys, I guess they've been outclassing me for years here. So I'm not exactly quite sure. But when I look at the numbers, I think Q42 being the best defender might be a huge difference maker. And for that reason, I think Cap Hazard, I think it's going to go three, though. I think Blue Hot Chili Peppers will win one. And Cap Hazard will walk it down and take the next two. But it also depends on the maps that we get, so that should be exciting to find out.
Asking them, the captains, yeah, and what's going on?
Yeah, and for my own part, I played Cap Hazard twice this season. We ended up, we played a total of five games. They won three of them, and we won two.
Oh, wow.
They were one of the most difficult tests that I faced all season. Probably the only more difficult test that I faced was TC Jukes, and they knocked them out as well. So yep. I just have a lot of trouble picking against them.
Did you have a chance to play against Blue Hot? Oh, okay.
No, I didn't. I'm kind of speaking more just out of my own experience, and I don't have experience with Blue Hot, but I'm going to take the evidence that I've seen. I've seen that Cap Hazard is an extremely good. And obviously Blue Hot is as well. They wouldn't have made it here otherwise. But I'm gonna pick the team that I know until they prove me wrong.
Oh, actually, yeah. I just got the pick, man. Hold on.
Oh no.
Started without me. What the heck?
Oh, Bolanka says it's gonna be a tie. That's fair.
That's just not what I want.
Y'all see that they started doing tie breaks at the end of the fifth set at Wimbledon. They never used to just play forever.
I saw the Federer match was 13-12 in the Joker. Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you inferring they should do something similar for Tag Pro?
Yeah, we should just like no, I'm saying we should do the opposite. Just keep playing. Fucking all night, man.
That would be pretty neat.
We run out of maps, but who cares?
I mean, it is championship week, and congrats to the Holy Seahawks for their win. They took home the Super. That's great. And congrats to both the B teams. I mean, I don't know if you guys had a chance to watch either of NLTPB, but both those games were phenomenal. And one went, as you guys said, into multiple overtimes. The other was just a back-and-forth slugfest. It was really fun.
Okay.
Hey, didn't you steal those words directly from a comment that I made on back and forth slugfest?
Did I really?
I think so.
I don't know.
I'm captain of, or co-captain rather, of Over the Pants. So yes, I have.
Oh, okay, that's great. I didn't know that. That's amazing. Yeah, great season.
Yeah, it's been so much fun to watch. Also, I have to shameless plug: Booper Ball will be on my channel on Wednesday.
I love it. I can't wait.
So,
The Nooper Ball tomorrow on Balanka's channel.
Yeah, that's going to be fun.
Cap Hazard ended up banning Sugar Hill. Blue Hot Chili Poppers banned Rush. And now Cap Hazard has picked Pilot 2.0. And that's where we're at right now.
Yeah, so that was kind of my anticipation was them. I like Pilot 2.0. I think it switches... the original Pilot up enough to make it a little more favorite... not favoritism, but it seemed to lean defensive heavy, and now it feels more even.
Yeah, it was like, it was a kind of a solved map previously, and even that small change, like I was critical of it when it first came out, just saying that like, it's not enough of a change. Like, you want to fix Pilot, you have to do more than, and FXU is asking, you'll see soon enough, but there's basically only one difference, which is that one spike was removed and one team boost, an offensive team boost was added. And it's really not a massive
change. They picked Emerald as the second map.
Nice.
Both teams have played Emerald a lot, so I'm not surprised by that. Although I will say Cap Hazard lost on Emerald in the first round. They lost 5-4 against the Gateful Dead, so.
Oh man, that was a fun game. Forgot about that.
The last ban was Transilio.
Oh, okay.
So now it is between Catch-22 and Jardim.
Okay. That's interesting, because they were both 1-1 on Transilio. Maybe neither of them felt comfortable. My guess would be Jardim, if what Amy said is true. It seems like they're secretly hoping for.
Mm-hmm.
And Catch-22 is a fun map, though. It would be fun to see that determine. And I think it's the first year it's been in the rotation for Miners or MLTP or TP.
It's the first season period.
Yeah. So it would be a good one to end on if we were to go that far.
Yeah, I really liked Catch-22. I did not expect to coming in, but I thought it was a really solid map. And I mean, there's a reason we've seen it played a bunch in the playoffs. And there's a reason why, obviously.
Man, they can really not decide.
I mean, personally, I think Jardim, like, it's just so much more exciting. Particularly, like, we're going to start with Pilot 2, which is, like, such a slow map. And then we're going to move to Emerald, which is, like, the complete opposite.
Right.
I think it'd be really fun to follow that up with Jardim.
And I wasn't surprised, I was saying earlier, by that Rush ban. BHCP just has not played it well this season, so it was smart of them to just take the one map that they're unconfident on, just get rid of it completely.
Yeah, that was a good call.
But I was surprised, because I did think they might end up the ban for Cap Hazard. I said two maps that they would ban, and they're both, they've already picked Pilot 2. And now they might pick Jardim as well. So I'm not exactly batting 1,000 here.
Well, we'll just focus on the good call. Forget the bad call.
Refined was called out Catch-22. I don't know if that's... Maybe that's just hope. We'll see.
And Jardim is the last map.
You bamboozled me. You bamboozled me, Refined.
So we have Pilot 2.0, Emerald, and then Jardim.
We have have they given us a link yet?
So yes, I will get that to you in 1 second.
Yeah, take your time. Thank you.
Okay.
We were talking about
switching
off. Oh, nice. Do you want to go first or second, Jen?
I'll let you go first, and if we're liking the way it goes, then we'll just stick with it. Yeah, we'll play it by ear. We'll figure it
out. Cool.
I got a... Oh.
These are the same maps as the Super Bowl, which is interesting.
Yeah, that is interesting.
It's probably just coincidence. Why do my jerseys... Ah, God, these Tag Pro scripts, I swear. Whatever, no jersey. What can you do?
Looks like Blue Hot Chili Peppers are ready to go, and we're just waiting now. On Cap Hazard.
So do your predictions change at all with these new maps?
Nope. Cap Hazard and 2.
So what were the map order again? It was Pilot to start, right?
And then Emerald.
Emerald.
Yeah.
I think it's going 3. I'm just not sure who's going to win. Because Jardim is just such a, it's a crapshoot, I think. So it should be really interesting.
See, it's interesting. People say that. I don't think Jardim is a crapshoot. It's very different from most maps, and it's a very punishing map. But I do think the team that plays it better wins more often than not. Now, I'm not saying the better team always wins, but the team that plays it better.
The reason I say it's a crapshoot isn't because I think it's all luck. I think it's because you can have like 1 minute where you kind of lose focus for just a minute, but that gives 3 caps because the map is so fast.
That's true, but isn't staying focused part of the game? Like, not losing focus is such an important thing on Jardim, I feel like. And a team that doesn't lose focus deserves to win more than a team that does.
Well, listen, I like to not focus for 10 straight minutes. I go 8.5 and I take a couple 30-second breaks in there.
Hey! Sorry, I'm watching baseball.
I thought you were watching the Bonds.
Yeah. Edwin Encarnacion with his second home run of the night, make it 4-2 Yankees in the bottom of the 8th. Because baseball on a tech bro stream. Sorry, I got distracted. Go Yankees. Gotta get that out here.
Alright, it looks like everyone's in the lobby. Should be starting soon. I really wish that my jerseys would work. But I have no clue how the new script works. Have you used it before, Amy?
No, I've just been using Poet's competitive.
Yeah, that's what I have.
Oh, yeah.
Can you set jerseys right now for you?
No, it works automatically once the team set their abbreviation.
Oh.
Assuming that it can.
Should we let them know they need to set the abbrev?
They should know by now.
Wow, Tantry's...
Tantry talking about machetes and kindergartners.
So if they set names like that, it will give me jerseys? I don't need to do anything?
Assuming that those jerseys have been updated in the script. So I believe right now it's going to give you jerseys for Blue Hot, but not for Cap Hazard.
Yeah, Cap Hazard doesn't... Oh, I'm sorry. I thought it was the other way around. I thought Blue Hot didn't have jerseys, but I guess I'm wrong.
No, Blue Hot's been around for a long time, so the jerseys got rolled into like old versions of the script. Cap Hazard's a new team. Teams that originated this season don't have jerseys in the script.
Gotcha. So what do you anticipate happening in the first minute of this game? Do you think they're going to come out swinging, so to speak, either Cap Hazard or Blue Hot Chili?
I don't think so. I mean, we've launched.
All right.
Pilot is, even with the changes to Pilot 2, I just think it's still a defensive balance map. Yeah, I don't know about you, but I'm getting Blue Hot jerseys, but not.
Yep.
Yeah, it is what it is. But yeah, it's a defensive balance map, and I think it'll continue to be that. But I think we'll see a bunch of teams probing each other to start, and we're
probing each other.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Oh yeah, like probing hard.
You have a
like,
way with words, my friend. Over the...
So Remo and GDR are eventually going to make it across the map to offense. And right off the bat, you see the difference in the map. Easy quickly with the chance, but Q42 just has the angle.
It's an interesting start. They're both starting with rub grabs, which I find generally don't work here on pilot. So we'll see as the game progresses if they get away from
bombs spawning and easy and dope going for an interesting play. Doesn't quite work out. Had one take the bomb to clear out space for the boost. Remo not able to get around Shrimpster.
See what first they do here for pups.
Here, yeah.
Dope with a great bomb, but not Remo able to get the angle. I think he had that angle. Took an interesting route, and Remo going to win the tag prayer. See if they can get out here. Dope just sitting on the boost. He's going to boost Remo back. Almost worked. Almost sent Yuki Yar into East. Not quite now.
Oh, no!
Dope boosting Shrimpster, I think, into the spike. It was almost a really good capping opportunity for Blue Hot right off the bat.
Nice snipe there by
Q42. Yeah, beautiful. Good positioning as well by Remo looking to make something happen, but Shrimpster's going to bomb back.
This is kind of what we expect for Pilot. It's usually a low-scoring map.
Second round of bombs. Really bad bomb by Remo is going to prevent Duke of Yore from getting the... If he can make it around Shrimpster, there's a rolling bomb. He's just going to go for it. Remo doesn't know it's still there. So that... Oh,
that's going to be a free one for
it's
Remo.
It's actually super good, though. They still got the RB.
Very well. Remo with the rolling and Juju's on flag. Going to defuse himself and all four ahead, though.
Great play by Shrimpster. Shrimpster playing well as a rookie. He's very maintained so far.
They take away one spike, still spikes himself on the other one. Oh, yeah. So I guess we can talk about the changes on the pilot map now that we see it.
Oh, horse fallen victim to the chain. That's I feel like it's like the Hornswoggle bomb. It always spawns when you try to take that boost. Every single
time. Dope should be out here. Oh no, Q.
Oh, he missed. Yep.
Q missing the boost though, and Remo
nice.
Fighting for the puppet Juki Yor.
Big pickup by Juki Yor.
That left pup is very late. It's gonna give. Oh yeah, it's gonna give Cap Hazard.
Oh, Q42, if he can get the solo.
No way you can hit that sniper.
Great hold by Dope.
Hey, if there is someone that could hit that snipe, it would be Q42.
I mean, yeah, but it was also an impossible angle.
I've seen Q42 do impossible things with it.
Oh, okay.
Good trap here. They should. Yeah, oh, nice block from Juki Yor. Great contained defense by both teams.
Yeah, I mean, been exactly what you'd expect, really. Both teams keeping their, just staying ahead, not giving up easy chances.
This is a real chance here for Dope.
This is possibly, but Q42 going to bring the tag pro in. Dope's going to look for the pup, I think. Should still have it uncontested. And just gets out of the way of Juki Yor. Juki Yor should leave re-grab here.
Both teams threatening here. One with tag pro, one with the
Dope.
Neither delivers, unfortunately.
Well, nothing happened with power.
Yeah, they kind of neutralized each other, even though one had a tag and one was the juke. They both used it intelligently.
This is a good out by Horace and potentially a chance. Remo pushing out. Now he's going to come back.
Good block by Dope.
Yeah, but he ignores Q42, just going for the grab, and he's able to grab and live long enough to end the chance. Remo going for an ambitious snipe, not able to make it. Juki Yor grabbing off of re-grab, going to make it to the boost. With the help of Sundown, he made it to the boost. But
it looked like Horse had the angle, though, even if he had hit it properly.
Thought he had a route, but I could be wrong. Sundown going to try to win the left pup as FC. Gonna have to abandon it and horse doubling up on the juke juice.
Great play by Shrimster. It's just very heady, very intelligent.
Well, as we predicted, Pilot is a defensive map where nothing happens.
It's very defensive, but we've seen some great snipes and some great defensive plays. I mean, it's kind of like watching the 2005 Spurs. You're just going to see Tag Pro played at like the most efficient level, and it's not all that entertaining, but like it's still fun to watch.
Big fight around mid pop. Looks like Caphazard is going to win it. Yeah, they do with the Juke Juice.
Now the right pop or the left pop.
Remo pass three.
Sundown with a bomb. Oh,
this is going to be the first cap of the game. Caphazard's taking a 1-0 lead. By the way, yes, I know that I pronounce Caphazard like Eden Hazard, and I can't stop.
It's okay. I support you.
I don't.
Oh, no. Oh, there's that double flaccid that you got to be careful
of. Oh, beautiful corner by Remo. Oh, nice play by Dope. The grading.
Saved a cap. Big play by Dope.
Good bomb by Easy. So 1-0, 3 minutes to go in this first half of the Mooper Ball season 18. Starting to get set up for pups. I believe it's mid, right, and then left. It's pretty. Sundown gonna go for. Great snipe.
That was very, very good.
Marimo gonna use his tag pro to secure a pup sweep. Oh, or maybe Juke of Yore able to beat out Shrimp Spear that. This is an excellent chance now for Caphazard. Gonna be past one with the tag pro lead. Dope sitting on the bomb. Smart. Gonna kill the tag pro just as it ran out anyway. Juke of Yore. They had the quick sandwich block.
That was a really nice return by Horace.
Yeah. And we're kind of back to the Pilot slog now. Dope and Easy trying that same play they tried to start the game as well. This time working out a little bit better. And
yeah, it's the block. Big play from Juki. Uh-huh.
Yeah, just able to shed Horace's block there. Q42 going to win a tag pro. Dope going to try to win the right pup, but not quite. And now Q42 with the lawnmower. Might even have enough time to take it over to that left pup, but he's going to go.
Oh, he definitely could have.
Instead.
He's going to grab.
Well, worst thing you have happen here if you're Caphazards is you have a lawnmower spawning in base. Best thing you have. Oh, I thought he took a kind of wide angle there. Not sure if it was there, but I think he could have made it a little bit closer.
He's still alive, though.
Nice move. Still contained, though. And now the grab's coming out for Blue Hawk.
Shrimster's there.
Oh, yeah, wow.
Beautiful blocks to make it a 2-0 game. Nice boost spawn for Horace. Oh, and almost a split there. Dope saying OMG. Yeah, that would have been dope.
Nice snipe by Dope, but Sundown's still able to get out on that. Oh, this is trouble.
That would have been a cap if they had gotten that defusal and return on Sundown there.
Yep. Smart kiss.
Really?
I think so. You want to get the ball into the. You want to get the flag on the.
That's gonna.
Yeah. You want it. You want to get it to the Juke Juice, and then.
Oh yeah, absolutely. I thought. It looked to me like Caphazards were. I forget who it was, but I thought they were the ones who were going for the kiss, and I. Yeah, I absolutely agree. That's a great kiss for Blue Hot as Remo making a nice move, but just going to get kept out of it.
Great OD for the most part. There was one small break where H made a grab that kind of cost them. They ended up giving up a capture because he got popped immediately, and it was a 3-on-2, and they got great blocks. But otherwise, phenomenal OD and exactly what you'd expect from. Yeah, Jam. Thanks, guys.
Okay. 2-1. Let's do some awards. How about that?
Hell yeah.
What do I got cooking here? I gotta find my awards shit.
Wait, you've got cooking here?
I've been cooking up some stuff, you know. Here we go. Okay. So we'll get some of the Miners Awards. How do I get this? There we go. That shows up. Okay. Most cohesive unit. Third place, GFD with 17%. Hey. Good job. Second place, Cap Hazard with 24.55%, and first place TC Jukes with 31.74%.
Wow. Yeah, that's well earned. TC Jukes, they just an incredible season. Not surprised to see Cap Hazard in there as well. A little bit surprised to see my team in there, but okay, I'll accept it. But yeah, TC Jukes, well earned. Congratulations.
And we'll do the best captain one now as well. Third place is Tantru from the Blue Hot Chili Poppers. Third place, oh boy, he's gonna have some words for the voters after this. Second place, Frothy for Cap Hazards with 21%. And first place is Poet with 35% of the votes. I can't really say who deserved what because it's almost impossible. I mean, I feel like it's impossible to know really what a captain does, but it's Poet, so.
Yeah, well, I mean, you look at, you got third place and second place, you have the two teams who are in the mood for ball, and then first place, you have the cap drafted GG, so.
True,
I mean,
you drafted GG, so. Okay, that'll be good for now.
We'll get of course, you could also say Poet rigged.
Yeah, that, you know, that would be exactly like Poet to rig votes. If there's one thing Poet would do, it's abuse the system and rig votes.
Absolutely. He's just a shady dude all around.
Yeah.
Oof.
Love you, Poet.
Dope just called out in comments, which is a good point. They got 6 tag pros, and BHCP got 0, so.
Yeah. I thought Camp Hazard did a very poor job with their tag pros. And I mean, really, that should have been a more high scoring game than it was. But I mean, I also think it's a really important skill to be able to win the tag pros, even if you don't use them, just win them and don't give them to the other. And, like, I don't really think of it as a chance lost. I mean, yeah, it is a chance lost, but you're also preventing the other team from a chance.
Yeah. So Cap Hazard taking a 2-1 lead into the second half here.
I think that the Blue Hot Chili Poppers definitely had the momentum, though.
Yeah, I mean, that late cap definitely. It'll be interesting to see. I mean, we had a, you know, not huge delay, but not a tiny turnaround either. So it'll be interesting to see if they can carry that. And Jam, you're up.
All right. Gonna call it fast and loose like a hockey game.
Nice.
Cap Hazard maintaining a 2-1 lead as we head to the final 10-minute frame here. Any predictions for the start of the second half?
2-1.
Slow and boring again.
All right. Nice double bomb there by Shrimpster, taking one of the offenders in. Easy and Dope grinding together now? That sounds bad.
Ooh.
What do you mean?
Dope has a grab.
Great.
Jukior, there's a double return. This is a troubling situation. Dope on the offensive. Sundown has the blocks. They get one, but Q42 makes a big play down the stretch, keeping the game 2-1.
That was a great play by Sundown, slowing down, giving enough time for Q42 to come.
Remo stayed 3D for a second. Now on the offensive, he gets a clean grab, and let's see what he can do with it. Getting the blocks from Sundown. He has the boost, goes inside. Still has the blocks from Sundown. Moving to the outside. The bomb, he's by it. He's past two. Opportunity. Juke blocking. Boosting in. Easy with the grab. Jukior able to escape for the moment is easy. Shrimpster getting back, and that will maintain the threat. Easy still holding. So is Remo. Remo with an opportunity here. Can't quite do it. He spikes himself out. And now after the round of pups are up, Sundown is in midfield. Jukior holding on the... Easy has still held the flag. And there's the kiss to reset things. Dope big snipe will clear the boards. 0-0 still. 8 minutes, 20 seconds to play.
We have to remember it's 2-1 or 2-1 for...
Yes, Cap Hazard, 0-0 on the half. Yeah.
Yes.
Cap Hazard is up 2-1.
So I would not be surprised to see them playing 3 defense if the score stays the same. Second round of pups here.
This is a big opportunity. Remo's going to get free at mid. Q42 grabs a juke and a juke for Shrimpster. Remo with it rolling. He's going to hesitate. Then it's defused by H. Good play there. Jukior. Showing us all that he knows how to spike. It's a 3-0 versus 3-D situation here, and Remo slices out. Opportunity gets by H. He's past Shrimpster, but Dope pushes forward, making sure the game remains 2-2. Dope has a grab. Good return by Q42. And still a defensive matchup. Remo is out. And now Remo's passed. This could be it. This could put Cap Hazards up 3-1. Great OD again from Easy. Nice play there. And now he's got a grab. The second time he's been able to prevent a capture. Oh! But oh, the pups caught him. And that's going to be Remo's slice, giving him a 3-1 lead now.
You hate to see that. That's just...
They have a rolling... Superman. Looks like they're not going to use it as H continues to hold. It's a good hold by H, though. He has an opportunity. Now they have the chance with two blockers in. He could trim this lead. A good hit from Easy. Doesn't quite get the block they wanted. Good contain by Sundown and Jukior.
Yeah, that's a really good push out. Phenomenal. Totally. Trust your teammate there because there's not really enough time to communicate. Okay, we have to trap him right here. You just have to trust that your teammates can see what you're doing and follow you because if only one of you pushes out there, that's
here comes Jukior with a chance. Juke's going to get sniped by H. And here comes another round of pups. It looks like H is going to get a tag pro in the middle. Shrimpster has a rolling block. Easy is out. So is Q42. Dangerous situation here. Cap Hazard, if they get a return, this will be a cap. Good protection from H, though. That was big. That could have blown this game wide open. Instead, they have an opportunity for a cap if they can somehow manage to get Q42. Q42 looks to get... That's a bad contain. Spot. Now Shrimpster is in a tough situation against Sundown. His dope hurries back. Easy still holding. Great hold from Easy in this round. He has the bomb. He has a 2-on-1. But Jukior read the play. Another threat diverted, and here comes Dope. A lot more pressure this game. It feels like there's a lot more hold than there was in game. Dope has it. He has angles here. He has a block on Jukior. Sundown is there. Good position by Sundown to make sure that that doesn't open the game. Another round of pups, and another run for Remo Slice. Easy again has to make a play, and he does so. Remo with the juke juice. Easy in tough situation from.
Surprise, Easy didn't kiss there. Getting...
Oof.
I don't. I think his hesitation was that he didn't think he could get there.
Oh, Shrimpster. Just absolutely savagely murdering his FC.
Pretty sure that's bannable, but.
That's a wout there.
We're reset again on both sides. Jukior looking at the boot. And Jukior will have a grab here. I don't know if he'll get an out. Gets a good block from Sundown. Bouncing between the tiles. Nowhere to go. Good contain by Shrimpster and H. Easy standing on the boost, waiting for the pup. Another round of pups. There's one for BHCP. So... seems like Caphazard is winning the pup war as Dope comes in with another opportunity. Oh, the miss block by Jukior. The chance. It's going to be good. 1-1 in the second half. 3-2 over. Q42 and Easy both holding. Easy just padding his hold all game. Easy getting through. He has an opportunity. The bomb is down. Oh, tough play there. Q42 still holding, though, as is Dope now.
Oh, God.
And Dope spikes himself. Oof.
JK.
He's keeping his wits about him, which is good. We talked earlier about how he might tilt. Oh, nice move by H. He gets around Sundown. Q42 still holding. Oh, this is a dangerous situation.
Man, Q42's hold.
It's been very impressive. Easy can't quite get him. Dope is out again. Shrimpster gets a juke juice and will get the return. Rolling for Remo. Rolling for Sundown. Dope pushing ahead. Dope past two. Past three. Now Sundown's ahead past three.
Interesting seeing Remo continue to chase while Jukior is on.
It was a smart play, yes.
Rolling bomb got diffused anyway. Probably would have tried to switch it up there.
That was a very close play. Dope somehow gets out of it. Now with a chance, he goes underneath.
Wow.
He is past three for quite some time. He has the bomb. Q42 is in an awkward situation, an awkward position, I should say. But Q42 finds a way out. In this game, it feels like one team has a chance. Oh, that was almost it. Feels like one team has a chance, and it ends up becoming an opportunity for the other team. Just counter after counter after counter. Speaking of which, here's Easy with a chance to tie. 151 to play. Off the corner. Does himself in. Mid-pup is up. Q42 gets it, but he spikes out. And there's a tag pro on the left side. It's going to go to Easy. Big opportunity here. Blue Hot Chili Peppers can bring it in. Let's see if the comms are there. They get a big return. This could be it. Sundown has the grab. Easy coming to protect Shrimpster.
Oh, God.
Shrimpster holding. Easy couldn't quite get it. And then now we're back to neutral. Still a 3-2 lead for Caphazard.
That tag pro looked like the chance that they needed
It certainly was, yeah.
Tie the game.
Is there anything you guys would have done differently on that tag pro?
I mean, just hid and waited. I think that was probably Shrimpster's inexperience there. I probably would have done the same thing. What am I saying? But
same.
It's much easier to see what you should have done when you're watching the game. And right there, it's just try to stay in one spot and let the tag pro come to you.
Both teams prioritizing pups here. Jukior gets a huge tag pro. Easy also gets a tag pro, though. And now there's still one on the left. It's going to go to Q42. He has a rolling. Dope holding. Dope is the man they want to have the flag, but so is Remo Slice. Tag pros kiss. Dope going back, looking for that boost, and he gets it.
Oh.
Low mid, but there it is. Wow. Big play by Sundown. Remo Slice puts the bow on the package there. 2-1 in the second half, 4-2 overall. Caphazard leads. Shrimpster hoping for a miracle. Somehow eludes. Q42 holding. Shrimpster still hoping, but Remo tags him, and that's going to be it.
Three.
Only question is if we'll be kept flags here. And the answer is no. 4-2, Caphazard take game one.
Well, Amy, your 2-0 prediction is looking pretty good right now.
Yeah, I'm the only one still alive with my prediction.
I said 2-1. So,
didn't you say that they were going to win? The PHCP was going to win pilot.
I have no idea. You might be right. I could be wrong. I just want to sound like I'm right.
All right, that's fair. We'll say you're right.
But yeah, I just remember thinking it was definitely going to go to Jardim, and that one would be a toss-up.
I think are you guys in the group still?
I've been booted.
Yeah, I think the group's dead.
Yeah, I think we need a new group.
In the meantime, let's do some more. Yeah. Oh, heck also, yeah. I was supposed to say there is a tournament that I think the signups are live right now on the competitive Discord server in the tournament section that's going to start right after the Mooper Ball, so you should sign up for that if you want to play. Okay, what's next on my award? Good. We have best offense pair. Okay, third for Miners is GG and Poet. 18% of the vote. Second is Bolanka and Neb with 20.8%.
They wish they got 28.
First is Refined and Team.
Wouldn't have been enough.
Would not.
Refined is a very good ball. So is GG and Poet, though.
Refined, you've done it.
Congratulations, Refined.
See you in the chat.
Congrats to everyone, actually. Bolanka, too. That's awesome. Second place is huge.
Yeah, I definitely want to congratulate Neb on winning an award when he goes.
Okay, let's do the best defense pair now. Third place, Q42 and Sundown. Second place, Suchet and Eldin. The percentages are very close. They're 21%, third place and 24% for second, and first place with 28% is Taurus and Nameless. Congratulations, Taurus and Nameless.
Huge.
Is that the first season Taurus has played on defense, or did he play last season as well?
I think this is his third season on defense third. Now.
Yeah, that's how little I pay attention.
Well, I mean, traditionally, he's definitely been an offender, but he switched to defense and just shot up the rankings in NLTP. He's a great NLTP offender, and he's a great MLTP defender. So,
I'm a big fan here of Jukior and Remo Slice getting upset that their defense wasn't ranked higher. Good teamwork, guys. That's fantastic.
Here's the new
Protector guys.
Oh, new group? Yeah. I should probably join this.
Discord.
Thank you.
We can fit in one more word. The FU gasp.
Ooh, what does that mean? So that means the gas doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Exactly. Okay. It's very aggressive. I didn't expect it. It was great.
Well, I have a spoiler for this.
Third place is Trippy with 16%. Second place is Easy with 24%. And first place, oh my goodness, would you look at that? It's If for Su Gaming.
Could it possibly be?
Wow.
That's big time.
That is a very meaningful award, and the game's starting. Yeah. We better go to that real quick.
Let's get there.
I don't have sound. I'm going to... No? There we go. Okay, we're good. Sound's on, game's on.
Cool. A bit of an ambitious roll there from Easy. Almost worked, though. Both teams waiting on boosts here. Reem going to come out and both these boosts spawning at the same time, but Easy is just going to wait on his. Waits for a flaccid, but not able to get the quick grab.
Oh.
Dope able to get a beautiful rub grab, and he's past two.
They have the gate.
Oh, they got the gate. Wow. And big.
To come in and make it 1-0 the Blue Hot Chili Poppers.
That's exactly level what this Dope series needs. Up.
Absolutely. And now he's got another out. He's going to take the boost. Got two ahead of him. Going to come around back into the graveyard. Back out. Looking for this boost. And he's going to take a lap. Look for pups.
Good hold. Oh, and he's going to get it.
Spawning. Incredible boost. Saving the cap.
That was
easy.
Unlucky.
Wow. Getting a great split. Sundown spawn. Still got a lot of work to do. And ends up dying behind the flag.
Dope's coming out very aggressive this round. It seems like he's
that's
got
the power
that chip
of
on his shoulder.
Yeah, if he comes off strong, he is going to take over.
That was a great out, but a beautiful snipe by Easy. Dope, heading back to this boost. He gets a sack from his teammate, but Remo just has the angle. Horse is past three. Juki Yor in the line of the boost, and Remo going to get a grab past everybody now. Horse has to back out. Now Horse getting his own gate. Not able to bring it in.
Right now, it seems like BHCP is just, they're outplaying Cap Hazard. They're just getting a little unlucky.
Cap here. Oh,
see?
Yeah. Yeah, that's exactly what you were saying.
But they just stay aggressive.
Gets a good bomb from Easy. Interesting rap, but might actually still work out for him. They got 2v2 blocks in base. He's got a boost to work with, but Sundown going to come around back and get the return on OD. Juki York makes something happen against Easy. He makes one nice move. He has two blockers in base, and he's out top. Dope going to grab. And he's going to get around the solo defender. Oh, Q42 somehow hitting that snipe around Easy's block. Shrimpster also getting the snipe. Shrimpster going to get ahead. And Sundown boosts him right into the return.
Got another round of pups coming up here.
This has been the exact opposite of like a game from the pilot, except they're still not really scoring.
Yeah, they're out. Oh, this is a big chance again.
Surely. Shrimpster gonna go huge. That's not what you want to see on defense from Cap. They're gonna make it into a Cap. Juke of your pass three, Easy gonna get ahead and get the return as well. Sundown grabbing towards the back of base, gets return. A second grab, death from Rima.
You guys think Dope, how is he playing in terms of mentally right now? He's had a few chances. Is he going to get frustrated, or is he pumped that he's getting out a lot, right?
I think he's pumped. I think he's good.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean,
you can tell pretty
quick his mindset, but I know when I'm getting out, even if it's not working, I feel like I'm going to make, if I keep getting out, I'm going to keep creating chances and eventually
another pup fight.
Chances,
this could be.
This is one for Dope. And
did you just see how...
That was awful, dude.
Yeah, BHCP is just, they're outplaying them mentally right
by
now.
Sundown, I think. And Shrimpster.
Another one.
That's not the route he wanted to take. Still could work out. He's going to end up kissing. Easy's got a Juke Juice on flag. Now it runs. He's going to have to cut back and boost back into his own.
That's not what you want to see.
Yeah. Dope heading back out to the boost. Cover the straight end, but has to wrap her over Juki Yor.
Great bomb by Easy.
They're at space for Dope. Sundown still ahead, but two in base to block. Sundown going to take that grab, and Dope has to back out a little bit. Nice corner move by Sundown, and a good block by Rima is going to get him out. Now, all of a sudden, maybe a chance the other way as Easy, who's leaving re-grab going for the pups, kind of gets caught between the two of them, and Cap has end up sweeping the pups, including a tag pro, and Remo chasing with the Juke Juice. Juke of Yore not on regrab, but he's going to manage to get ahead. Q42 doing a good job. Remo ends up being Juke of Yore getting the return, and the tag pro does the job, and Dope says, Jesus.
There could be the tilt. But here, if there were an opportunity, like a statistic that monitored the opportunities, I would say right now BHCP is about 2 for 8, 2 for 9, whereas Cap Hazard is probably 2 for 3 on their opportunities of scoring.
Yeah, there have been a lot more opportunities for Blue Hot, but but Cap Hazards have definitely been a lot more efficient with the opportunities that they have had. And getting those pups was massive. That pup sweep and attack pro did so much work. Now Remo going to be past two as well, but Dope in exactly the right spot, knows exactly where he's coming. Pup's about to spawn. Bottom pup is first.
Ooh, take
and yeah, huge opportunity. It'd be really interesting to see how Cap Hazards play this. And Sundown not going to be able to do anything here, and Dope's going to bug. Oh, he could have gotten longer. See, I feel like if you're going to boat with two tag pros, you might as well at least let the tag pros get ahead.
Yeah,
like,
I don't know why Easy stayed in base there. Weird. Definitely could have gotten another grab out with that.
Yeah. But anyway, the rub is 3-2 lead for Blue Hot.
Yeah, I think Blue Hot right now is happy with how they're playing. Up 3-2. Getting a lot of opportunities.
Yeah.
Feels like if they're going to lose this game, it's going to be their fault right now, which is exactly how you want to feel in a playoff game.
Yeah, absolutely. It's interesting. Last three rounds of pups have all been sweep. One for Cap Hazards, then one for Red Hot, and then one for Cap Hazards again now. And Juke of Yore with the Juke Juice on flag coming in, but... Oh, bad boost.
Good,
or maybe
good
a good boost.
Solo there, but I do.
And they had a rolling on flag. Oh, but he had Rav.
Oh, no.
Oh, man. That's got to stink.
Yeah. I mean, you can't get gated there. It's as simple as that.
I mean, he made so many great jukes to make that play happen, but that's a heartbreaker to lose
yeah.
it. But Dope, he looks fine. He's already back on.
Dope now, pass two, coming in low. Sundown has to boost out. Dope gets a really fortunate boost spawn. Can't make anything of it. And Remo now, pass three the other way. Easy, not in any danger. Just going to sit on the gateway for the boost. Runs into Dope. Says hi, going the other direction.
You know, hey, how are you? Oh, they abandoned the...
Interesting.
I thought that was... Yeah, they were leaving for Easy, but he decided not...
Yeah, I mean, I always feel like at this level, a competent juker does not need a juke juice on flag. Like, you give the juke juice to the flag carrier in pubs, but at this level, I think that was the right decision to give it to your chaser.
Well,
now, Sundown going to have to do a lot of work and plays great OD.
That's huge.
And promptly celebrates by boosting into a spike.
Took me a second to register. That was fun.
Oh, nice move by Duke of Yore.
Dope's just holding forever. We're going to have to check the hold after this match.
We get return now.
Oh, we tried to get cute there. That could cost them.
Easy. Looks for the kiss initially, but he's just going to take it out of base. Now he's going to get
the
kiss.
That'd be a great time.
Smart kiss. Pups are up. Last round. Another sweep.
This wheel is really dangerous for Cap Hazard. Yeah, and they do have two in base, and Sundown going to come around and get the return. Shrimpster defusing his rolling bomb. Not able to get a grab off of it. Dope coming in, going for the split. Not able to either. Shrimpster off of regrab, and this could be trouble, but for whatever reason, who was that? Remo spurning the boost. I thought he could have been out there, but... So 15 seconds to go and 3-2 lead. It's been really honestly more of the same from what we saw on Pi. I mean, at least in terms of scoreline, been a lot more open of a game, but
3-2-1.
Yeah, I thought, oh, that'll get him a kept. Both teams get a kept. Hey, all right. Yeah,
Dope, 3 minutes of hold on Emerald.
Wow.
He's almost tripled the people who are next high. Really impressive outing from Dope and just putting the team on his back, and that's when they really needed him.
I still think if you look at both teams are probably happy right now because BHCP, it really felt like they went about 3-for-14 on opportunities there. Whereas I felt Cap Hazard went maybe 2-for-4, 2-for-5. So I think both teams are pretty comfortable going into that second half.
Alright, I'm gonna do a couple more awards. Best valued, third place Nameless, second Bolanka, first place GG. Gotta give that one to GG.
Congrats on the super appearance to GG as well. Great job from a rookie major player.
Most improved, third place Nameless, second place Bolanka, first place GG. Was that the exact same as the one before?
That one feels like a Bolanka to me.
Well-rounded, third place Nameless, and tied for first place with exactly 28.07, Q42, and GG.
Well, that cracks me up because they were ranked third as best defense, but now they're both the best... most well-rounded.
And we'll do one more, the fifth ball award. Third place to Yep with 20%, second place PK with 22, and first place to ASAP with 22.6. Congratulations, ASAP. You got your name up there.
Huge. I want to point out that Clout9 had 2 fifth balls, apparently.
Yeah, that's...
that's interesting.
Shouldn't it be like sixth place, like the sixth ball for PK?
It feels like that's like when Manu Ginobili kept winning six men of the year and everyone said it was garbage.
We're just going all in on the Spurs references here.
Oh, yeah. I'm a big Spurs fan of that era. I just got to figure out a way to make a Tony Parker stealing your wife joke and then we're good.
Well, I'll just wallow in my sadness, isn't it? I'm going to grab some water. I'll be right back.
All right.
Sounds good.
I think they're just about to launch. There we go.
All right. Second half here. 3-2 in favor of BHCP. I expect more of the same from BHCP, being hyper-aggressive with grabs, trying to make more holding opportunities. What are your thoughts, BC?
3-2.
I wasn't listening. What?
Yeah, you love to hear it. That's great. Jukior, the first grab, he'll get returned by or horse. I'll start saying the full name there. Juke with the second grab as well. And he might be, he's actually out, as is Dope on the bottom side. Juke is returned, Dope holding again. Easy, had a good anti, so a good situation here for BHCP. Dope, another good angle.
Oh,
gets the bomb from
God,
Easy. That's a cap. Great play nice by bomb. Easy. Great move. And there's the kiss to make sure nothing is taken back immediately. And it's now 4-2 in favor of BHCP. 9 minutes, 5 seconds to play. We're coming up on the first round of pups here.
Easy's had a couple, maybe two or at least three, very nice plays with bombs in both ends of the map.
Yeah. Q42, accidental grab with the tag pro, but he gets out and he's passed to. He has to watch that back snipe. Easy picks him.
Oh, Amy, you missed the cap.
Oh, did I?
Yeah.
That was a good one.
I heard you guys yelling, but I didn't see.
Defense is locking down here in the second game. Felt like they were frequently in the first, but here comes Dope. Just as I have to bite my tongue. Nope. Good return by Q42. Good double contain here on horse. Remo a flaccid. 8:15 to play. Dope, another grab. He's playing very confidently, and he gets out again. Easy tried to get the gate. And just Jukior will get returned here. We're going to be reset. Second round of pups here. 4-2 in favor of Blue Hot Chili Poppers. Easy, or I'm sorry, Q42 getting the return, and horse getting it rolling. Diffused by Sundown. Horse gets the grab. Easy pushes him up and out, and he's over past two. Q42 with the juke chasing. Remo slice chasing. Oh, blocked by Dope. Brilliant block. Nice evasion of the snipe. And now horse dancing in between the mid tiles, waiting for that juke to go out, but Q42 still gets. Great gate there by Shrimpster. Once again, back to neutral. 4-2, Blue Hot Chili Peppers. Remo with the grab. Somehow evades a couple, but nothing happening there as Easy tried to rush in.
I think you're seeing the flag carriers really get into their groove. The micro jeeps are on.
Yeah. And also, to that point, this second half, the defense has locked down a little bit more on the double containing and making sure they're getting returns in key situations. Another round of pup, round three of pups here. Juki, you're rolling, taking it back to defense. Shrimpster rolling, pushing it to offense. Juki, you are now on regrab with that rolling. Dope holding, return by horse. Dope is going to be out. He goes topside, gets a block, gets a gate, has the bomb. Juki, you're holding. Juke is somehow getting to return by horse. Big return there, and we're once again, well, not quite reset as Remo has a free grab. Hesitates through. Big chance here from Remo. Easy has to make a big play. He cannot do it. And they cut the lead to one.
Potentially another chance, but he slows down for some reason.
Dope with an accidental flaccid grab there. Here comes Remo Slice with a chance to tie. Hits the bomb. Goes in, and he's done it. 4-4. Brilliant play by Remo Slice.
I think that's the cap of the game so far, unless the one that I missed was...
No, that was better.
They were similar.
Remo did it all himself there.
Yeah, Easy helped on that other one. And here comes Remo Slice, still with the juke juice. He's going to be out top past three now. Good boost ahead. This game is tied at 4, so we'll see what happens. Or is it 3?
Yes,
bomb here from Remo.
Remo going for the same... play, but not quite working out as well. Needed that boost to spawn.
Both teams reset yet again. Shrimpster and Easy on defense. Sundown and Q42 playing D on the other end. There's an out. It may be a nice handoff. Juki, you're ahead. Hits the brakes. He'll have to take a lap here, but he does have an opportunity. Easy tried to push him through, couldn't get it.
Oh, this is a
Shrimpster.
Good chance.
Oh, Shrimpster bit a little bit. Nice, great play by Dope on OD. And now it bombs out. He has a chance, but the spawn of Juki Orr hurts him. Round five of pups. Juke juice for Q42. Juke juice for Remo Slice. Big opportunity. The Juke brothers on Cap Hazard. I feel like you should have grabbed
person.
There.
Yeah, that's the wrong person to grab.
It was a tough situation, a tough read. I think Q felt he had a great block, so he wanted to maintain it. It doesn't matter. Remo is out anyways. Past Dope and H. Sprinting up. Shrimpster in a tough position. Dope pushing hard. Easy's got to get there. Dope does get. No grab. Smart play.
It was a bit too aggressive of a boost. And
he could have taken a lot.
Well, I mean, he boosted all the way across the map.
Oh, Easy, that boost block.
Dope with a big chance to put him back up one. He hits the bomb. Has a chance. It's going to be a race. He gets it. Shrimpster with a chip block may have helped out. And now.
Oh,
up and ahead. Easy has to get there.
Oh,
nice. So now it's 5-4 in favor of Blue Hot Chili Peppers. 3 minutes to go. Round six of pups.
Sorry, I'm just going to commentate exclusively in gasps.
Remo boosting topside. Shrimpster, ooh, they let out a free grab there, and now it may cost them. Great position by Dope saves them.
See, that time I think Remo should have gone for that.
Yeah. I think he almost didn't because of the last time.
Yeah, maybe.
Remo has a grab here. This is another opportunity. He gets by Shrimpster, showing the NLTB player and what a Miners player is. And that's a cap. We're tied again. Unreal play. Great timing. And now Shrimpster looking for the counter. The other end.
Oh,
yes, indeed.
Dude, it's a shootout. You're going to get me banned if you keep this up.
Oh,
nice
wow.
Snipe there by Q42. Big play getting him with the game. Score is 6-5 in favor of Blue Hot Chili Peppers. 2:53 to go. Round 7 of pups. Ooh, and Juki Yor gets a tag, bro.
And Sundown.
Coming
on Easy's leaving the base.
Oh, that's a free cap. If I've ever seen one. And now Juki Orr will wait as the game's tied.
Juki's on flag as well.
Great
bomb. Q42
Easy
still
is,
might be out there.
You get past
Easy
Dope.
He's just been a master of the bombs. Good. Dope didn't get the return, but he did enough to like slow him down, which should have been enough for the team, but Shrimpster is waiting. This is... Shrimpster on anti. Easy is out. Q42 holding. Easy being chased by Juki Orr. Q42 low on the backside. Bounces off the wall. He has the open angle, easy, evading a snipe. 2 minutes to go. It looks like we're going to hold for the eighth round of pups here. Sundown, a big return. Q42. Oh, dope's missed. And that's going to cost him.
Oh, that's a tilter right there.
That's a big play.
If I've ever seen one.
Dope does get a roll, but then he takes it to defense and spikes him out.
And fancy. If you're dope, I feel like you have to think as well. I mean, I'm not sure if this is going to be the mindset that he has, but you have to think that really should have been a cap earlier. I'm 100% sure that Q42 had that, like 30 seconds before he ended up capping. So that's not the worst play ever, but I would not be happy right now.
Uses that bomb again.
Oh, and Remo going to be
punished too. Though, DHCP down one suddenly. They've been controlling most of this game, and it might be down two. Oh, boy. This could be it. The pressure's on now for these young balls.
This next round of pups is so important, and Remo being able to grab and get out before pups. So much more difficult for Red Hawk, because now they have to play OD and also think about pups. And Remo,
Shrimpster rushing Dope with a grab, a big opportunity. Easy plays it perfectly to maintain it, but they still have the blocks. That's going to be it. You're looking at your move for champs, I believe.
I think that's GG.
That was a huge cap. Cap hazards weren't. Remo, another Blue Hot Chili Peppers weren't playing re and still got capped on there.
Dope should get one back here. Still 35 seconds to go. It may not be over yet. They need two. Sundown, not going to quite get returned. Shrimpster gets him, but Shrimpster will then be gated. Nope, easy saves him. 22 ticks, they need to do something.
I don't think Sundown's getting returned.
He's not going to be able to do it alone, and Sundown's just holding.
And Remo has left Toxic.
Remo's gone.
Going to fuck up.
Not quite sure why.
Oh, he didn't hold out. Oh, KL is getting his moop.
He got the mooper minutes.
I dig it.
GG's.
There you
have
it.
It looked like BHCP could have had it, but they've, in the last 4 minutes there, they just couldn't quite hold on.
I think that was
Cap Hazard.
Yeah, really great composure by Cap Hazard to not worry when they were down, just kept playing their game. And I mean, you trust the process, and the process took them right to the Mooper Ball Championship. Congratulations.
And it was a reversal from the first game to the second game. It seemed like BHCP was out a lot more in the first game, and then it was just the opposite. Remo had taken over the role of Dope, and he was out every few seconds. So
let's get the last great season for both in here if we can.
Let's get these last ones in. Okay. Defensive rookie of the season.
Well, that's got to be Nameless.
Nameless, 100% of the votes. Huge.
He's the only defensive rookie.
With the offensive rookie of the season, second place is Jerry with about 50%. First place is ASAP with barely 1% more than him. ASAP taking home 2 of the trophies so far.
Oh, man. Jerry got robbed there. I'm sorry, Cap Lord, but. Yeah, Jerry robbed.
Defensive ball of the season. Third place, Suchet. Second place, Thick Shady. And first place, Taurus. Congratulations, Taurus.
Good job, Taurus.
Yeah, that's obvious, as you can see from the almost double margin from second to first.
And offensive ball. Third place is Dope with
no need, boys. It's gonna be me.
11%. Second place is Poobie with about the same, and first place is GG with.
Oh, yeah. they misspelled Jeremy Jam. It's fine.
Unlucky.
Oh.
Congrats, GG.
Yeah, you had almost triple there percentage. The most valuable ball MVB. Who's it gonna be? Will it be GG
or is it? It might be Taurus. I think Taurus.
Let's see.
Has
third
a very
place.
Strong argument.
Q42.
Oh, yeah.
Second place is GG. So you gotta got to look at Taurus here. Yeah. First place, Taurus, with over 2% higher than GG.
Congratulations, Taurus, my man.
Have they done All Stars yet?
All Stars are out. I don't know if they're in that
sheet, though. I think we normally post them on the subreddit.
That's all I got.
Okay. That's great. Great season, boys.
Yeah, so, I mean, thank you, Jeremy and Amy, for commentating. You guys were awesome.
Thanks so much for having us.
Yeah. Thanks to Twitch chat. You guys were so well behaved, unlike whatever happened on the Discord before the game.
Oh my god.
Very good job. Hey, thanks for Bob for all the bits. You're so kind. And congratulations to... Holy shit, I forgot who won. Brain lag.
Cap Hazard.
Woo! Yeah, congratulations.
Cap Hazard in two, just like I said.
Easy clap. You're so smart. Okay, bye-bye.
I know.